There are 16,800 magazines in this country. But only one calls itself the in-flight magazine of Air Force One. And that's the thrill of working at the New Republic. This kid, he hacked his way into a company called Juke Micronics and posted the salary of every Juke employee on Juke's website, saying the big bad bionic boy has been here, baby. I want a trip to Disney World.
It's funny.
Why didn't you get this?
I don't know.
Do you have phone numbers for all your sources on the hack haven fees?
Could somebody let's do some kind of follow-up story?
I called all the hackers I know, asking if any had heard of a hacker by the name of Big Bad Bionic Boy. Nothing.
He's made some pretty serious charges.
This looks very suspicious to me.
I'm increasingly beginning to believe that I've been duped.
The New Republic's snobbiest rag in the business and gets completely snowed.
Have you thought about the impact this might have?
If you fire him, people will leave.
I go, Chuck, why didn't you back me up? He goes, I'm sorry, Steve. I gotta protect the magazine.
There are political considerations.
The Young Conservatives piece. Was that true?
This wasn't an isolated incident. He handed us fiction after fiction, and we printed them all as fact.
What you're telling me is impossible.
If he were a stranger to you, you'd dig and you'd bury him.
But there is one thing in the story that checks out.
What's that?
There does appear to be a state in the Union named Nevada.
Hayden Christensen.
You're my editor. You're supposed to support me.
Peter Sarsgaard.
And this thing blows, there isn't going to be a magazine anymore.
I didn't do anything wrong. You saw my notes. Everything was in there.
They're going to have all this, too.
I didn't do anything wrong.
I really wish you'd stop saying that.
Shattered glass.
I just want you to tell me the truth.